All right, so thanks everyone for joining in. My name is Nick, as you all know. I've started recording this session, and today it's the fifth session of the digital marketing course. As of now, we have covered quite a lot of stuff, and that's what we'll start with. We'll definitely go ahead and do a small recap, and we'll talk about the topics which have been covered. Follow to that, I would request each one of you also to do type in across the questions, queries, any doubts you have, so that I can go ahead and help you with that. All right. Just give me 1 second. Hello. Okay. All right, so let's get started, guys. I would request each one of you, I believe, Prasenjit, you can hear me. So I would request you to do type in across the topics which you remember from the previous session. Perfect. So we're getting started with today's session. I would request you to take your time and do type in what all do you remember from the previous session, and then we'll move ahead. And the other participant we have is Bala, but I can see Bala is not able to hear. All right, so I believe you must be typing in for sure, and I'll wait till the time you go ahead and type in across in the chat window what all topics have we covered so far. All right, okay, no problem, Bala, if you're not able to hear, it's absolutely okay. All right, so Prasenjit, it's only you as of now, and we are starting this session. Like I said, if you want me to unmute you, I can unmute you as well, because it's only you. I can give you the privilege of, speaking and talking what all do you remember, and then also using the audio chat version to ask across your questions, whichever way you're comfortable. I mean, I'm not saying you should do that. It's absolutely as per your wish. If you want to do the audio chat, or you want to comfortable doing the typing, the text chat, that's absolutely okay. Whichever way you want to do it. But would like to know from you, what all topics do you remember from the previous session? I generally go ahead and ask, audio chat is okay. Let me just go ahead and unmute you. Give me a second. All right, Prasenjit, I have unmuted you.
Hello, Nick.
Hey, hi, Prasenjit.
Yeah, I have one question regarding the past few sessions we have crossover.
Yes, please tell me.
So, see, after finishing this course, will I be able to, design a web page so that I can get my business in my local district or state?
Oh yes, so did you attend the very first session? Did you attend that? Because in the very first session, I have covered the overall topic of how to create a website.
That time you told me that I can go with that particularly state, I can map with that.
Mm-hmm. No, but let's take first. you said that whether I can create a web page. See, creating a web page is number first thing. And in the very first session, when did you recall the first session? Were you part of it when I explained how to get a domain and a hosting and then connect them and get across a WordPress installed on your website?
Yeah, right.
Right, right. If you follow those steps, your website would be there first. Your website will get created. Any single page of your website could be used across for your ads and so forth. Now, what is the next question? I think your first question gets answered, that your website, your web page, how does that get created?
Firstly, I have to purchase this through GoDaddy.com.
That's correct.
Then, yeah, just a minute.
If you're not able to recall these steps, I can definitely share across the recordings with you for the first session, second session, which you can, you know, refer again and follow those same steps.
Yeah, just a minute.
Sure. Hey, hi, Goresh. Welcome to the session. I can see Goresh has also joined in. So, Goresh, I did unmute Prasenji because it was on the Prasenji to join in. And we'll get started in with our session in a while. I'm just taking across questions and queries. If in case, Goresh, you also have got question queries, please do type that across, or I can even unmute you after once Prasenji is done. Goresh, you got any questions, queries? Feel free to put that across in the chat window. Also, would request you guys to do type in across the topics which you remember from the previous session so that we can take it further from there.
Yeah, Neil, can you listen to me?
Absolutely, Prasenjit, yes.
First of all, I have to buy this domain through GoDaddy.com. Then after that, I have to buy the hosting. That is, you just given the name of Hostgator.
Yeah, absolutely. Hostgator. You can buy from Hostgator, or you can buy even from GoDaddy itself, whichever one you're comfortable. Yeah.
Okay. So I have to purchase this personally, right? This Nitin cannot help in this regarding this matter, right?
No, Nitin will be helping in this, because Nitin is going to give you all this. So I was just showcasing you the entire procedure, but Nitin will be giving you these. So each one of you get across a domain and hosting.
Okay. Okay.
Yes.
So that means when I'm getting this domain and hosting, then I have to go to the settings and I have to, then I have to go to the settings, right?
Right, right.
Okay. Just, can you just recall once again that when I will go to the settings, then what I actually need to do?
See, if Nitin is going to give you, then you don't need to even go to the settings option. Because Nitin will give you everything, like domain hosting will get connected, and also WordPress will be installed, and you will be given across your WordPress details.
Okay, so if Nitin is providing these details, then I am to do nothing with this kind of settings or all
that. Absolutely,
things.
But after that, you have to start working on your website in terms of putting content, putting images,
right,
and then getting it optimized, which is search engine optimization.
Right, exactly.
Right. And Goresh, I can see your chat. Nitin was supposed to provide some login and password, but yet I'll just check with him, Goresh, today, and I'll keep you posted either tomorrow or by Monday, positively. Perfect. Any further questions, any further queries, guys? Goresh and Prasenjit? Prasenjit, any other query you have?
No, till time it is okay. Let us start the new session.
Perfect. All right, so I'm putting you on mute, Prasenjit, and I'll start with you.
Yeah, surely. Yeah, thank you so much.
All right, guys. Thanks so much for asking in your queries and also letting me know that it's all good. With regards to the website, domain, and hosting, I'll definitely ask Nitin to assist you and so forth. Let's move ahead. Let's move ahead in the sense that I will go ahead and talk about, first of all, the topics which were being covered across previously. All right. So in the last session, we did start across pay-per-click advertisements, right? I hope everybody remembers that. And we did understand what pay-per-click is all about, right? Pay-per-click is nothing but it's a term used across whenever we as marketers are approaching Google to go ahead and promote across our website, the product and services on our website through the paid mechanism. All in all, we would be paying to Google for every click which will be done on our advertisement, all right? We understood that there are various search engines and PPC is just an act of buying traffic from search engines. Not just the search engines, but we also understood that PPC is the paying mechanism which holds true when we publish across our ads on third-party websites also, and that's nothing but it's the display advertisements. We understood that display ads are shown across on third-party websites, which are, in other words, called publishers, right? We understand the overall mechanism, of how publishers, advertisers, and the website visitors, they work across, and there are different products of Google. One is the Google AdSense, and the other one is AdWords. Just trying to check with you guys, which particular product does the advertiser use? Is it the AdWords or AdSense? And which particular product the publisher use? Is it the AdWords or the AdSense? Just trying to check with you. Advertiser uses AdWords or AdSense, and publisher, which one publisher also uses? All right, guys, you can let me know whether you remember and recall these things. If don't, then I can definitely go ahead and talk more in detail about it. So Koresh, do type in across the topics. If I can request you to type in across the topics which you remember from the previous session. I hope this AdWords, AdSense thing was being covered across. I had made you understand what exactly, right, perfect. This was being covered across. All right, so I'll talk furthermore. So we were talking about the paid ads, guys, and the very first form of paid ads was the image ads, which comes across in the search result. The other name given across to these paid search image ads is Google shopping ads. And the product listing ads. I did tell that these shopping ads are created with the help of two major Google's product. Google has got several products. Google has got Google Analytics. Google has got Google AdWords, right? Google has got Google Merchant, Google AdWords, AdSense, and several other. But these shopping ads are created with the help of two major products, Google AdWords and Google Merchant. Google Merchant Center, guys, is exclusively used by advertisers for the creation of these shopping ads. And they can only be created. Another thing is these shopping ads with the price attached to it, which comes underneath in the search results, in the search engine result page, they are only created by e-commerce websites. When I say e-commerce websites, websites which have got a payment gateway option where people can go ahead and pay across and get across, what do you say, their product being ordered, they can order across their products by paying across with the help of their credit card, debit card, net banking, and so forth. All right. Those are the e-commerce website. Then we went ahead and understood what is the second major form of Google marketing, the paid ads, and it is the search text ad, this one. The way we identify across a paid search text ad is with the help of this ad symbol, which is right next to a search result, all right? On a search engine, whenever there is a search query we typed in, there are several search results which comes in. The first one which we saw was the shopping ads. The second one which majorly comes across is the search text ad results, all right? This is a text one. It's an ad because it's right over here. and it's on the search engine result page. That's why it's a paid search text ad, right? This is the second form of paid pay-per-click advertising. We do not have an option to showcase these search text ads on any other Google property. For example, we do have an option like Google Maps, Google Drive, and so forth. We'll understand how that is being done. They all together are called Google Search Network. Okay. I'm saying it again. One can show across these search text ads, guys, not just on the search engine result page of Google, but also on other properties which Google owns, like Google Map, Google Drive, Google Mail, and many more, which are owned and operated by Google. All right. They all together, these Google's property where text ad does appear, guys, are collectively named as Google Search Network. All right, Google Search Network. When I say Google Search Network, it means the Google Search Network in itself means all those websites which are owned and operated by Google, which are, for example, Google Map, Google Drive, and Google Mail. So other than Google Search Engine result page, we can showcase across our ad on Google Search Network also. We'll see when we do the practical version. All right. Now, the other thing is, any kind of a website, whether it's e-commerce or whether it's non-e-commerce, they all can create across the paid search text ads, guys. Okay. Other than also Google, there are various search engines like Bing.com, Ask.com, and many more other search engines, which offers marketers the opportunity to promote their product in the paid and the unpaid section. Do you want to see that? Let me go on to Bing.com, guys, and show you this. So Bing.com, which is the second most popular search engine, even if we type across any search query on Bing.com, there will be paid search text ads over there also. So it's not just Google, guys, which does offer this opportunity to marketers for promoting across their website, or in other words, promoting across their product and services with the help of search text ad, the paid search text ads. Bing also offers that. So this is Bing search engine. Let's say I'm typing across a specific keyword, which says buy iPhone 7. All right. Now this is a search query out of the blue. Now, as you can see, there is this ad symbol right over here, guys. And then there is ad. Bing shows across advertisements also on the right hand side. As you can see, there is an ad on the right. There's an ad on the right and there is ad on the right. There are three advertisements on their right hand side of their search engine result page. And also there is one advertisement, which is right over here, right? I hope everybody is clear on this. Wherever you have, guys, have any question, feel free to put that across in the chat window so that I can go ahead and answer that respectively. Let me just take a snapshot and let you know. So this is one of the ad. The other ad is this one, and then this one, and then this one. So this is, if we talk about this, this is the search text PPC ads. So these are the pay-per-click ads, right? Even these ones work across on the pay-per-click mechanism, guys. Pay-per-click. These are the search text pay-per-click ads on Bing search engine. Similarly, there are several other search engines which do offers across this opportunity, guys. This opportunity of showcasing across their product, their website on their search engine result page. All right. So we saw this. Also, the other thing is, when I was telling you that the search text ad comes across on Google's property other than the Google search engine, like Google Maps and Google Drive and so forth. Here was the screenshot. Here's the screenshot which depicts this. So whenever somebody types in across a specific search query, even on Google Maps, there is an advertisement, guys, which does appear. I can show you live. Let's see if there is one which comes across. Well, let's say I go on to maps.google.com. Prasenji says, our ad is always reflecting in PPC. Absolutely. So this is one of the way through which we identify which one is an unpaid and which one is a paid way of promoting your website. Ad is always right next to those search results, which are being pushed and promoted by the advertisers with the help of the money which they have, which they are paying to these search engines. So in this case, Walmart, Amazon, and so forth, they all are going ahead and spending. They all are going ahead and spending across a certain amount on every click. Whenever there's going to be a click on these ads, there's going to be an amount, a particular price, which these advertisers will pay. So ad is always there. That is absolutely correct. All right, the moment I clicked onto the Walmart advertisement, this page opened up. Now, I just failed to understand. Walmart is doing pretty wrong over here. Wrong in the sense that I am based out of, I'm not based out of, United States as of now, and I'm being shown across a web page which is primarily focused towards the United States audience, and this is Walmart hasn't created a great ad. So I am in the region which is somewhere in India, New Delhi, India, and I'm being offered across this ad, which is not absolutely a good way of marketing. All right, this is one of the observation which I did. Now I'm on to maps.google.com, guys. Let's say I type in across a word, a search term which says restaurants. Now, let's just try to see. There is no advertisement which has come up over here right now, but usually the advertisements do come. Whenever the advertisement comes, it's not that every time an advertisement will come for sure. There can be situations when advertisements are not there. All right, so I don't see any advertisement as of now. Nevertheless, but it's not that every time the advertisements will not come in, guys. Somewhere or the other, advertisement, let me try this one. All right, not even with this one. All right, so these all are the organic ones, guys. These all are organic ones. But nevertheless, I believe you have understood this. Prasanji says, how this paid service is justified or what basis charged from the client. On the per-click basis, the amount is being deducted from the client's credit card or debit card, Prasanji. I hope this is what your question is, that on what basis the amount is being charged. And you say how the paid service is justified. The paid service is justified when you, as a marketer, try to produce across, try to get across conversions at the end of the day. Conversions in the sense, revenue to be generated. Now, let me take an example. If I am going on to Google and let's say there is a search term which means digital marketing, or not this one. Let's say I'm typing across a search term which is buy iPhone 6. Now, as you can see, Prasenjit, in this case, Flipkart has created across a search text ad, and they're showcasing and they're representing their search text ad. Similarly, Flipkart, eBay, ShopClues are showcasing their shopping pay-per-click ad. Now, the way it's been justified, let me answer this first question of yours. whenever somebody will type in buy iPhone 6, whosoever or the internet users, I mean to say, on the internet, whosoever needs across an iPhone 6 and types across this search query only, and let's say they click onto the Flipkart website, the moment a certain proportion of people who looks into these ads, you know, goes on to Flipkart, they will either buy the product or they will leave the website. Now, let's say 100 people in a day, 100 people type in across buy iPhone 6. Now, out of 100, 100 times the Flipkart ad has appeared, or let's say out of 100 times, 90 times the ad has appeared, and for the rest 10 times it didn't appear because of several reasons like bid not being so high, quality score being down. Now, what is a bid and what is a quality score? I'll talk about that in detail as we move further. Let's say out of 100 times this search term has been typed in, the Flipkart ad is shown 90 times. Now, out of 90 times, not every time this particular ad will be clicked across. Now, let's assume out of 90, there are 40 times this ad has been, clicked across. So 40 new visits Flipkart receives across, and on the basis of these clicks, Flipkart will be paying an amount to Google. So 40 clicks multiplied by whatever the cost per click would be. Now, how that cost per click amount is being decided and come up, how does one get to know about that? That's also a separate thing which we'll talk about. And this is a long thing behind that. Now, let's say for 40 new visits this website, which is Flipkart, got, out of 40, not every particular person will buy across a product. It's quite obvious that certain people might leave the website, certain people might close it, certain people might stay on the website for long but do not end up buying, and certain section of people, a certain percentage, will end up buying. Now, let's say if I'm talking about Flipkart only, out of 90 times, for 90 clicks, you know, the payment was being done, and let's say every click was, the actual cost for every click was 10 rupees. So ultimately 900 Indian rupees will be the total amount which Flipkart will pay for the 90 clicks, right? I'm saying it again, for 90 clicks, the payment will be made, and 10 INR was the average cost per click. 10 INR, average cost per click, which is CPC. For every click, 10 Indian rupees was being paid, and total 90 clicks, Flipkart received in a day. So 900 Indian rupees was the total spending. Now, let's say out of these 90 clicks, only 40 people went ahead and purchased the product. So 90 people came, all right, 90 people came on the this particular web page, and only 40 purchased. Now, 40 conversions, so 40 sales or 40 conversions figure we have. All right, this is how the overall justification will be given. The justification in the sense that, let's say, every conversion is giving us 27,990 rupees to Flipkart. So if you do 40 multiplied by 27,990, that would be the revenue which Flipkart would have received. Now, out of that total revenue, there would be a certain cost, you know, which Flipkart has got, that will be deducted for every price. Let's say every particular iPhone 6 which was getting sold was offering 2,000 Indian rupees profit. 2,000 Indian rupees profit per phone sale, per iPhone 6 sale. What it means is 2,000 if it's the overall profit for every iPhone 6 sale, and there were total 40 sales which happened. It means 40 multiplied by 2,000, which gives across 80,000 INR profit, guys. 80,000 INR profit, and it happened after spending 900 rupees. Well, this is a very exaggerating figure, guys. Usually, you do not get that amount of conversion, like 40 INR, 40 conversions, right? 40 conversions or 40 sales for 90 clicks. For 90 clicks, you might get 3%, 4%, 5%, or maximum 10, 15%, right? So, out of 90 clicks, let's say 9 sales were there, and 9 sales multiplied by 2,000 gives 18,000 profit. Hope that answers across your question, Prasenji, that how do you justify this? You justify this overall marketing spending to the overall marketing head, to the overall business head, or to the financial head on the basis of the numbers, on the basis of the sales which you were being able to achieve. because of the cost per click ads or the pay per click ads. Let me know if you have a follow-up question. I can answer that also. All right. Rajendra says, God, ROI is too high in this case. Yes, absolutely. This is one of the cases, a hypothetical situation, percentage. Usually, like this much percentage of conversion rate, this much conversion rate isn't there. It's way too lesser than that. But still, you have to do your mathematics and come up to, you know, and you have to look the numbers, whether it's going in the positive direction or is it going in the negative direction, right? Perfect. Let's move forward. Now, once we have understood this, I'm moving back to my document once more. All right, we understood the search ad, text ad appears across in the Google Maps also, and they appear across in the Google Mail, right? That also does happen. And this is one of the example of search text ad appearing on Google Mail as well, on the right-hand side. Okay, we understood what Google Search Network is. It's all the websites which are owned and operated by Google where text ads can be displayed. So Google Map, Google you know, Mail, and so forth are part of it. All right, now when we start with the Google AdWords, guys, Google AdWords as one of the product which we have to use for promoting across our product and services, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 different kind of networks. The paid marketing, if we talk about, is always done across with the help of a Google product called Google AdWords. Google has multiple products, and this product is only meant for the marketers and the advertisers, the digital marketers. These five major networks, guys, are search network first. Search network consists of all the ads which gets created and shown across on the search engine result page. Then it comes down to the display network. Display network ads are the ones which are floated across on third-party websites. I hope I did talk about this. Now, let's say if I go across on a website, did we speak about this? The Google AdSense part or not? The display ads. If I go on to ndtv.com and I am, let's say, one of the advertisers, I want to showcase across, I'm, let's say, Flipkart only, and I want to promote across my product onto NDTV, let's say, with the help of a banner ad. Even that happens, even all that process also happens with the help of Google AdWords. Google helps in these kind of advertisements also, whether it's a banner ad, all right, or whether it's a video ad on third-party websites. Over here, we've got a banner ad on NDTV, which is of Tata and also of Rento Mojo and so forth, right? And also of this another website called Urban Ladder. Now, these advertisers who have bought across space on NDTV's website, these transactions have never happened directly. They all have happened with Google being the middle person in between, right? Google does take into consideration all the advertisers. Google has got a network of advertisers in one side of the corner, and the other side of the table is Google has got a network of publishers also. So Google's network of publisher like NDTV in totality is called Google Display Network. And any website can be part of the Google Display Network and earn money by offering space, right, to advertisers by approaching Google. And that approach, I mean, that procedure to approach Google is with the help of Google's product called Google AdSense. All right. Prasenji says, so here Google is playing monopoly role, more or less, absolutely. More or less, that's correct, Prasenji. So Google gets, you know, gives across opportunity to various websites like NDTV and so forth to mint money or to monetize their content, whatever effort they are making in terms of creating content and managing their entire website. They have to, so NDTV.com and all these players, they have to go ahead and overcome their expenses and earn more profit out of it. And the way they generate revenue is with the help of this space only being offered. All right. The space is being offered by NDTV with the help of the product called Google AdSense, guys. I believe I did tell about this also. Let me just go ahead and log into Google AdSense and show you this. Give me a second. All right, so I'm just logging into a couple of one of my accounts and remain the other one. So Google AdSense, guys, allows various different website owner to go ahead and create across their advertisement, or sorry, their account with them. It's called google.com/AdSense, guys. All right, so I'm logging into this. The moment you guys also have a website, and instead of an advertiser, instead of going ahead and promoting across your website, you know, by creating ads and showcasing that ad onto various third-party websites and also promoting across your website on the search result, you can go ahead and make money. Instead of spending money, you can make money by offering space onto your website. If you have good amount of traffic, if you've got great traffic on your website coming from various different places, very different digital marketing channels and so forth, and you have a fan following, whatever you want to say that, whether it's a fan following or whether it's a good amount of traffic, then it gives you an opportunity to go to Google AdSense and apply for a Google AdSense account. Once the approval gets done, so while appearing, while connecting with Google AdSense, Google AdSense always asks for various different questions related to what's your business name, what is this business all about? What's the website name? How much traffic the website has? And how are you planning to promote it and so forth? Okay. Now, once the application gets, accepted, the Google AdSense application gets accepted, then you go ahead and, provide across space to Google, and Google will do its part of providing this space ultimately to the advertisers who are approaching Google through Google AdWords, guys. Now, this is an AdSense account, guys. As you can see, now this is a very, I don't use this much, and it gives me information about, the kind of revenue you have generated and so forth. Now, this is for the last 7 days. I can even go ahead and check the performance for much older time. So this is showing for 3 months. All right, so this is the overall performance in the last 3 months and so forth, the amount of money which has been made. So as a publisher, I have received across this much dollars and so forth, in total $79 and so forth, right? I can get to see my performance report. I can see which all player have I allowed to showcase their advertisement on my website and so forth. I, as NDTV, when I'm on to Google AdSense, I have the opportunity to go ahead and even restrict. I can restrict across certain, I can restrict across certain advertisers to showcase their product and service on my AdSense account. All right, that can also be done. Hope that helps. And let me know if in case you have any question, guys. Are we all clear with this, with all this, whatever we have spoken so far? Prasanjit, Goresh, are you good? Let me know. We need to sign up. Absolutely. You need to sign up for this. All right. So this is about AdSense, guys. It is a free service. Absolutely. So you don't need to really pay across anything to Google for this. It's just that you need to have a great website. That's the number one thing. And when you have a great website, it should have traffic onto it. right? Because Google needs to cross websites with traffic onto it and so forth. All right, so moving back, we understood all this, and I'm coming back again to the kind of ads which Google allows. Search network ad, I had shown you, the one which appears across on the search engine result page. The display network ad, I've shown you the ads which appear across on the third-party display websites, right? Whether it's like NDDV or there are several other websites or other publishers like NDDV, where the advertisement can be floated across of your choice. A lot depends upon whether it's a great targeting or not. So targeting is something which we'll talk about in detail. That'll help us to identify and understand how do we go ahead and create ads and target them so that the right set of people only get to see them. Then comes in the other form of paid search marketing, guys. The paid marketing, basically, it's just shopping. So shopping ads is also one of the paid search engine marketing. And then the video ads is purely about, you know, creating a video, small video advertisement and floating it across and promoting it across on the YouTube videos before any actual video gets played or within the specific actual video and so forth. That all is possible. One can select the actual videos before which our ad should come, or in between of which the ad should come. And then the other one is universal app campaign. This is purely with the overall objective of getting more apps download, guys. Okay, now talking furthermore about the display ad, guys, I did tell that with this sort of a Google advertisement, the Google paid Google ads, this is not part of the paid search engine marketing because they do not appear across on the search engines. That's why this banner ad is not part of the paid search engine marketing, guys. Now, these display ads, whether it's a banner ad or an image ad or a text ad, all of these, if we talk about, these are the different ad types. So display ads have got different ad types. The banner or the image ad is one. The video ad is another one. And the text ad is another one. All right. Now the place where these ads, guys, are being placed, are going to be the third party websites. Websites which are not owned and operated by Google. So the video ad I'm talking about, the place where these video ads are placed are going to be third party websites, you know, the display ones. Websites which are not owned and operated by Google, right? It's websites of someone else. Makes sense? I hope so. Let me know if in case you have a question, guys. Now there is fourth form of paid Google ads, guys, which is called the video ads or the YouTube ad. This ad type is not part of the, again, paid search engine marketing because it's definitely not the search engine. It is the video ads. And fifth form of Google ads or the pay-per-click ad, guys. Let me write it across. It's the universal mobile apps. This ad type is not the part of search engine marketing. All right. Now we understood across the structure of the Google AdWords account. Do you guys remember that? Anyone? We did talk about the Google AdWords account structure. All right, was it being covered? Just trying to check, Prasanjit. We had done that. All right, so I'm just going to be quick on that also. We understood that there is always a structure and account structure, guys. And the reason why a Google Ads, this I remember. All right, perfect. An AdWords account structure is taken into consideration just for the purpose of making things easier for the advertiser. The advertiser will know what all different advertisements they have created, in what all the under sections and so forth, right? So we have all the accounts level at top level, then we have the campaign level, and then underneath the campaign level, the level number three is ad groups, and then underneath every ad groups, we got level four, which is ads and keywords, right? Which is ads and keywords. So keywords for one ad group will show ads from that ad group only. Different ad groups can have different keywords and so forth. Now the level one, which is the account level, that's the AdWords account. And we're taking across an example of Amazon. So let's say Amazon AdWords account or Amazon homepage, whatever it is the level one, right? So the Amazon homepage or the Amazon AdWords account, that's level one. The website URL, which will be promoted within the Google AdWords account, is one thing which needs to be mentioned at the account level. And all the other things which are mentioned at the account level, you'll see when we'll work on it. The time zone, the country billing, the currency, the billing, which is the credit card, debit card, and bank transfer. You have to enter the detail for that in the level one. And then the notifications, right? If in case there are several notifications coming across, you can go ahead and stop the notifications to jump into your email box and just make them restricted in the Google AdWords panel only. So that's up to you. So this is level one we spoke about. I'm not moving further in much more detail just because we are doing a recap. Level two was campaign, guys, and I made you understand that level two is very similar to having across the category page of your website and so forth. So level two of your website, let's say, can be this one, the Amazon's page, which does have got the category and so forth. Whether the campaign one name could be mobiles and tablets, the campaign number two, could be the other, what do you say, category, which is, let's say, like the books and so forth. So one of the campaign being books, the other one being the movies and tablets and so forth. So through these, the categories have been used across as a campaign, and that's one great way of going ahead and dissecting across your Google AdWords account. Now at the campaign level, the majority of the settings are being done. Majority of the settings are like, first of all, at the campaign level, it's been asked what campaign, what network type, on what network type are you going ahead and, you're running a campaign, you're creating a campaign. Is it a search campaign? Is it a search network or a display network or a video network or a shopping or a mobile app? I have shown you all of those, right? Then it'll ask you at the campaign level for what device, whether it's a tablet, desktop, mobile, or all three of them, or any two of them, on which you want to showcase your ads. Then comes in the location. In the location, you enter across, the place where your end audience is found across, right? So location can be changed across from country to country or any other thing. So you can even go ahead and type it across any country, any state, any city code, the zip code, or the radius targeting can also be done. All right. And then at the campaign level, you also mention across the budget per day and the bid for the very first ad group and so forth. All right, so hope that helps, guys. So campaign settings, I also understood, maybe you understood that there are two campaigns, let's say, and at the same time, they are running across on different, networks, search network and display network, and one of them is using across desktop and mobile devices, and the other one is using all device. The very first one is using across the Los Angeles, and the other one is, let's say, the other one ad is running across for London. And similarly, the campaign one has got a budget of $500 per day, whereas the campaign two has got a budget of $100 per day. So paid search accounts can have multiple campaigns with different settings altogether. All right. Then comes in level three, guys. Level three is the ad group. In the ad group level, I made you understand the under the overall category page, there are subcategories. There are subcategories. So what we can do, there were, let's say, a couple of ad groups. sorry, there were a couple of, there's just one of the ad group, which is mobile and tablet, and underneath the mobile and tablet ad group, there are three advertisements and so forth. Oh, sorry, this is an ad group basically over here. There were three campaigns. So there are two campaigns. One is the books and the other one is the mobile and tablets. Underneath the campaign comes in the ad group, and the ad groups are being created with the help of these subcategorization being done. These subcategorization. So the first subcategorization of books. Book was the campaign one, and underneath that, underneath the books option, there are various other dissections like children and young adult or books by the Indian authors and so forth. Now, with that being said, these ad group of C1, ad group of C1 and the ad group 3 of C1, all right? This is the campaign one. When we say C1 as in the campaign one. So we got ad group number one, ad group number two, ad group number three. All right, and Prasenji said, what is the maximum number of campaign one can do under one account? It's 10,000. Underneath one AdWords account, there are multiple AdWords, multiple campaigns which can be. And that number of maximum number of campaign, it's underneath one account is 10,000. So 10,000 in all campaigns can be there, and every campaign also has got 10,000 maximum ad groups which can be created. So because of the limitation of the, you know, space, the overall, can't show that how much it is. All right, just try and check here a second. All right, not this one. All right. Hope everybody's okay with this and is clear onto what we have covered so far. This was just a quick recap. All right, so similarly, ad group number one, two, and three of the campaign number two. All right, then comes in after the campaign level, guys, is the ad group level. So very first one was the account level. Then the ad group, then the campaign. So account level, campaign level was the level two, and level three is the ad group level. Now at the ad group level, guys, settings which you have to configure are the ad copy content and the keywords to be used. All right, we'll see that also again. So underneath every level three, there is ad copy content and also keywords which needs to be used across that needs to enter. All right, so that's at level three. All right, so we understood the PPC and the PLA ads. And these PPC ad guys, they always have certain elements and dissection. It's always headlines at the top. Then comes in the display URL and also the other one. All right, so the top section of the SERP, guys, can show maximum 4 paid search text ads. I hope you guys are aware of that. 4 paid search text ads are possible under the top section of the SERP, basically. And there cannot be more than paid search text ads on the top section of a SERP. More than how many? More than 4 paid. So more than 4 paid search text ads on the top of the top section of an SRP. So we just have one as of now. We can have 2, 3, and 4, not more than that. Can you explain PLA? Absolutely sure, Prasenjit. PLA stands for product listing ads. All right, the other name given across to product listing ad is called the Google Shopping ads. And they are only created across for those websites which have got e-commerce functionality and so forth. So only a shopping website can have these. Makes sense. Let me know. Only those e-commerce websites which have got number attached to it. And they also work across in the pay-per-click funda. All right, so Siddhi said that means an e-commerce site by only having PLAs. Well, e-commerce site having only PLAs is not the one. It's so only and only a come, you know, a website with, so means a com, that means a commerce site only having PLA. The e-commerce, right, absolutely the e-commerce, right. It's the e-commerce website only that only has got PLA, the product listing ads. Absolutely. Like these ones are the e-commerce ones. All right, so we covered this part and then the unpaid search results. When we talk about the unpaid search results, there are certain elements of a unpaid search results which are default, all right. Else, so over here, if we talk about, this is the overall level number, another level after the campaign. And here, the overall advertisement, which is the paid search text ad, it has got some default elements like heading on the top and then the description on the bottom and then it's the URL over there. Now, anything which is more than the, what do you say, more than these major default elements, they all are called ad extensions, which we're going to talk about. Okay, I just want to tell you with this, these paid search text ads, they are always made up of multiple things, not just the overall, there, what do you say, these paid search text ads, they would not just have the only default elements, but also more than that. The default elements, if I talk about, the default elements are like the headline on the top, which you're seeing, all right? Then you have the description line, then you have the display URL and so forth, all right? And there is a mechanism for creating across these ads, and we'll talk about that as we move further. Now, this is nothing but these are the organic listings. And organic listings in a day in a particular search engine result page can be maximum 10. All right. Maximum text organic search engine listing can be there, guys. Maximum 10 search engine listings in the organic section can be there. I hope you guys remember that the paid ads. What is the number of paid ads, guys, maximum on a search engine result page? All right, hope it makes sense. So 10 maximum search engine listings, the unpaid one, 4 maximum the paid one, the 4 maximum paid search text ads, they cannot be more than the paid search text ads on the top section of an SERP also. That's something different. So what it means is maximum 4 text ads in a search engine result page. In a search engine result page, maximum four paid search text ads can be there on the top and in the bottom at the same time. There can be 3 search text ads. 3 search text ads at the bottom part of the search engine result page. And in the middle, there are maximum 10 organic listings in an SERP. All right, hope that makes sense. Let me know with a yes or no. Goresh and Bala, are you able to listen and follow? All right, so let me know if the overall hierarchy of the Google account was clear. Any questions, guys? Koresh and Prasanjit, I could let me know. All right, thanks, Prasanjit, for acknowledging trust. I appreciate that. Now, with that all being said, we also understood the Google Display Network. I made you understand that Google Display Network consists of all those websites, the pool of all those publishers which have offered space on their website to advertisers in order to earn revenue, right? This is all about earning revenue. Publishers do it only with the help of Google. They all want to make across money for the traffic which they are receiving. Like I told you, NDTV is receiving good amount of traffic, so they can go ahead and monetize that. So publishers do it with the help of Google. Publishers contact Google with one of the Google's product called Google AdSense, and on the display network, many different form of ads appear on the display network, absolutely. Whether it's a text ad, whether it's a banner ad, whether it's an image ad or a video ad. All right. All right, so I'll talk about matrices later, guys. I have to move further ahead with my presentation. Just give me a second. These were still paid search, Google AdSense, and oops, 1 second, this is being signed out. I'm just gonna sign in and access this, give me a second. All right, just give me a second. All right, so I'm just logging into this Google Drive account and thus use across my presentation for the same. All right, so this is what we understood the other day. I believe, all right, so Chaitanya has also joined in. Perfect, thanks for joining in, Chaitanya, and all. Also letting you know, you have missed, but you can go ahead and check that across in the chat, in the recorded section. All right, so search engine traffic, we understood that it is purely an act of buying across traffic. There you go. All right, so we understood PPC is an act of buying traffic from the search engines, and companies, they do use PPC to buy traffic through search engines like Google, Bing, Ask, and Yahoo. So each one of them have their own way. And search engines show ads or sponsored results, guys, which are search ads often positioned at the top of the search results page. All right, so search engines show ads or sponsored results, which are search ads often positioned at the top of the search result page. Also, over 6 billion search queries guys are being recorded daily on the search engine. So it gives a lot of, a room for going ahead and spreading across product, message, and so forth in front of so many search queries. And also search engines, they do divert relevant queries to your business website, providing potential customers, all right? So it's all about getting across potential customers. Display network, the other day we understood that there are three forms of display network. One is the text, the other is the banner image, and the third one is the video ads. And these two come across, these are all different ad types are being shown across on third party websites, which are part of the Google Display Network. Now these ads, whether it's a banner image ad or whether it's a video ad or a text ad, they appear across on the basis of the keywords, user interest, right? We spoke about that, contextual targeting, and the remarketing. Any questions with regards to this? We have covered this, and that's why I'm just being quick onto it. If you have a question, feel free to stop me then and there so that I can go ahead and answer your question respectively. All right, just give me a second. All right, so your ads can choose the ad format, either to be text or an image or a video ad. And once one of this is being chosen across, there are various different, after the ad format, there are various different targeting options, which we understood last time. So the targeting of these ads, which we create, can be done on the basis of the keywords, the user interest, and the contextual targeting, which means nothing but it's the same, which is keywords, contextual targeting and keywords, and then the remarketing. Right, so ads, the banner ads, the image video ads, the text ads, they do appear across. On the basis of keywords, user interest, contextual targeting, remarketing. I hope everybody remembers that and recalls that. Also, my ads, whether it's a banner ad or a video ad, can be shown across to only those set of people who have been to my website before, right? They must have come to my website with certain thought, and I'm trying to pull them back again by offering them a remarketing option, right? With the help of remarketing, you can do that. Now, the other thing, guys, with paid stuff is the auction-based. Did we cover this part? Just help me recall that, please. The auction-based system. You recall that, Goresh, Prasenjit? Okay. I think this is where we have to really start with. Now, when these ads, these paid ads, guys, when they run across in the search engine result page, which is, let's say, as I'm taking Google across right now again, and Google, I'm typing across a search query. Again, a similar search query. Now, what I mean to say, okay, there are two search engine ads, guys. Now, whenever there is a search query, guys, being typed in across by a certain person, which says buy iPhone 6, all these players, the paid ones who are running across, who are showcasing across their product, they're showcasing it just for the purpose of selling them and making them visible and so forth. Now, shopping ads is one. The other one is Flipkart. This paid search text ad, if we talk about this paid search text ad, which is by Flipkart, and the paid search text ad, which is by Amazon, they both have got a certain per click price which they would be paying. I'm talking about auction based system, guys. Now, Flipkart might be paying X amount of Indian rupees per click, and Amazon might be paying Y amount of per click, all right, whenever there's a whenever there is a click on this ads, on these ads, then only these advertisers respectively, whether it's Flipkart or Amazon, they both will pay across from their pocket to Google, all right? Just because there are clicks being received onto them, onto these ads. Now, if we talk furthermore about the pricing, guys, which these people pay, whether it's Flipkart and Amazon, on per click, they are based upon another input which the advertiser puts in, and that's called a bid, guys. Bid is nothing but the maximum amount which an advertiser is willing to pay. All right. So if I'm Flipkart or I'm Amazon, I would go ahead and tell Google that, you know, this is my bid. And let's say my bid is way too less than, way too less as compared to the others. In that case, my chances of my ad being on the first page top position is going to be very rare, and so forth. And the other player which we are seeing over here, it's Amazon. They are ranking on the second most position. The question is, what is it that, you know, one has to do in order to be always on the top and not fall down and not get fluctuations and so forth? Now, the Amazon ad guys or the Flipkart, they all are paying a certain per click price. They all are paying a certain per click price whenever there's a click onto them. Okay. Now, these per click price guys is decided across a specific thing that's called bid. Okay. Now, bid is nothing but it's just an amount, maximum amount, which each of these advertisers are willing to pay. All right. So Flipkart puts in across a bid in its AdWords account. All right. And similarly, Amazon also puts in across a bid in its AdWords account. Okay. Now nobody knows who has bid the other. What is the bid of the second other person and so forth. That is not visible. That is absolutely not visible. And in this, whether it's Amazon or Flipkart, which have agreed, I mean, which agree upon, you know, paying across a certain amount per click, they might not be paying that same amount which they're bidding across. All right. Now, what do you bid for and what you get charged are two different things, let me tell you. So it might happen that Flipkart might, you know, Flipkart might say that I'm willing to pay 100 Indian rupees per click. Bid is absolutely on a keyword. That's correct. Bid is on a keyword. So Flipkart says I'm ready to pay 100 Indian rupees per click on this page. And similarly, Amazon also says that we are willing to pay 110. So Amazon is willing to pay 110 per click and Flipkart is willing to pay 100 rupees per click. Now, it's not that the moment there is going to be a click on Flipkart, it would be 100 rupees per click only, which will get deducted. And with Amazon, also, it's not going to happen that it will only be 110, which will get deducted. All right. Not 100 or not 110, which will get deducted and so forth. And these advertisements, these two advertisements, like I said, they appear across in the overall. One second. So just trying to see if that's visible. All right, not. So they all, guys, they both are putting across an effort in order to get their web page on the first page, first position. And for in order to get across your website on the first page, first position, in the topmost position, there is definitely a bid which plays a role. And also there's another thing which is called quality score. So bid multiplied by quality score gives across the ad score. And the ad score for not just Flipkart and Amazon, it's definitely there for all the all the other players and so forth. So each one of these players are putting across a bid, and the amount which they each one of them are willing to pay is 1 cent or 1 rupee more than the second highest bidder after you. Right? So the second highest bid after you, you have to take that and add 1 single cent in order to come up with the actual cost per click. Let me show you with the help of an example over here. Now let's say the example that showcases the bid amount is not similar to the actual CPC. Now in this example, the actual CPC guys is penny more than the bid of the personal second highest bidder after you. So it all starts with, let's say we've got four advertisers, A, B, C, and D, and the advertiser A has put in a bid of $5 per click. Advertiser B has put in a cost of bid of $4 per click. C has put in a bid of $3 per click, and a D, which is $2 per click. Now, these are the overall bidding guys which they are willing to pay. All these advertisers. Now, what is the price which advertiser A will pay is going to be second highest bidder underneath you, and then one paisa more than that. So for advertiser A, the second highest bidder, let's say, was advertiser B, so $5. Right, so this is the for the advertiser B, it's basically going to be $3.01 in total, and for advertiser C, it's going to be $2.01, and advertiser D, whose bid would be $2 per click, right? The actual cost per click comes out to be $2. All right, so this is to do with the overall amount. Example that showcased that bid amount is not similar to the actual CPC. Right, actual CPC is always, for all of these, one, it's always penny more than the highest bid amount, second highest bid of offers across and so forth. Now, with all these biddings, I told you that the bidding is different to what we pay. So if it's $5 for advertiser A and $4 for advertiser B, what A advertiser will pay is 4.01. This one, the advertiser A will pay 4.01, advertiser B will pay, right? So advertiser pays across 4.01, and advertiser B, who has got a maximum amount of $4 per click, but what's the overall amount which they have to pay? Advertiser B will be paying again 1 cent more than the second highest bidder underneath you, which is $3.01. And then if we talk about advertiser C, advertiser C has got an actual cost per click of $2, and right. So advertiser C in this case, guys, will be paying 1 cent more than the second highest bidder underneath you. So for $3, it's going to be $2.01. Right, and in the end, advertiser D will pay $2 per click only, which they have agreed upon. All right, so this is to do with the bidding part. Now, budget, guys, what is the difference between budget and a bid? Now, budget is something, guys, which is always put across by the advertiser as a daily thing. Now, today, if I've got a budget of 200 Indian rupees, I do not want to spend more than that, I can put that across in two adverts. Just giving you one example. Right, so advertiser budget is always put in across by the advertiser. Now, let's say a bid, guys, bid and budget, in order to understand this. Let's say there is an advertiser A. Advertiser A has bid in across $5 per click, and the actual cost per click is $4.01, just because the CTR for the person who's second highest bidder after you It's 1,000. So that's why. So this is the overall budget, is the overall thing across by the advertiser as a daily thing. So advertiser A, like I was saying, has got an actual CPC of actual cost per click, which is occurring across as $4, and budget is, let's say, 401, 402, total clicks is 200. In that case, impressions comes out to be 600, let's say. Impressions means the number of times your ad has been shown. Okay. Now let's say your ad was being shown across 600 times, and along with the impressions, the clicks will also be there. All right. Now the clicks, if we talk about, in order to understand the overall performance, it would be clicks divided by the total number of impressions, which is by 600 multiplied by 100, gives you the click-through rate. And the total cost is 100 multiplied by 4.01, which is 401. All right, so the total cost is 100 multiplied by $4.17, which becomes $4, and so forth. Hope it makes sense, guys. So budget is always put in across by the advertiser as a daily thing, because one has to look into the entire panel and then come up with the overall learnings and so forth. All right, so we got another one example. This overall is called ad rank calculation. Well, I'll talk about ad rank calculation as we move further, guys. It's not right now. I hope it's all clear. Let me know wherever you have any doubt, guys, so that I can tell you and train you further. One second. All right, not even here the paid ads are coming across. Nevertheless. All right, so auction-based system, guys, you understood that there is an auction. Every advertiser is going to be putting across an amount which they're willing to pay per click, and not more than that, plus the actual cost per click and the overall auction-based one. The auction and the actual amount which you pay are, they're two different things, right? So auction, first of all, the paid search is an auction-based system, and paid search auction decides the ad positions. So one of the great thing which paid search auction does is that it decides the ad position, and how it does, we'll talk about that. You only pay for the traffic to your website. Whenever somebody clicks onto your ad and comes onto your website, you only pay for that. And paid search is an auction based system, right? Where each of these three advertisers have said, I'm ready to pay this much, I'm ready to pay this much, and I'm ready to pay this much. So paid search auction decides which one will be on the first position, which one will be on the second, and which one will be on the third, and so forth. It's not at all like the only bidding amount is being looked into consideration for deciding the advertising, guys, the advertisers, advertising position. There is bid, and also one more thing, that's called quality score, which determines. All right, that determines the overall position and so forth. Now, as an advertiser, you pay only traffic to your website. Now, the other thing, guys, which targeting or capabilities are there in the paid search ads and the display ad both are as follows. Whenever we as an advertiser are creating across an ad, we do have an option of picking up the geographical location. If I know that my end audience is very much concentrated towards a specific city and so forth, I can go in and run my ads only for that city or for that state or for that country, you know, so that you get across better results for the limited budget you've got and so forth. You know, when you have decided on the geographical location, that automatically filters out the unwanted, you know, once again. unwanted places where, you know, where the ad should not come. So let's say if you have selected a city, which is New Delhi, and you have created the ad and so forth, then your ad will only be shown by people within that specific location. All right, so that's, so ads are displayed across on the geographical business location, and then ads are displayed according to the time and date also. Now, time and date, guys, if I talk about it, this is pretty much interesting. This works across very well for a local business if we talk about. If I take across even geographical, if I take across example of a, I'm not sure whether this was being covered also or not. You can let me know. If I have got a, let's say, a restaurant, I can go ahead and select across the nearby location from where my majority of the traffic comes in, or majority of the conversion comes in. Similarly, I can decide the time and date when I want to show my ad. It makes sense to show my ad only for those time and dates when the conversion rates have been higher. Also, I can make a lot of formulation, a lot of rules over here, which decides that, let's say with my restaurant, the banner, the breakfast ads, the lunch ads, and also the dinner ads. So there are separate advertisements being created to promote across all the different meals of the day. So the banner ads we can define should run across only for 3 hours in the morning. Then display ads work, you know, display ads are being shown only in the lunch display ads. The lunch ads are being displayed across during the afternoon hours, and also the evening ads are displayed across and during the dinner hours and so forth, right? So the ads are displayed according to the time, the date, the day of the week, and also the geographical location. Plus, other targeting capability is that you can select different ad formats for different devices, guys. Right? Different ad formats for different devices. So let's say I want a video ad only to be run across for a mobile device. I can do that. A text ad only to be run across on the search result, I can do that, and so forth and so on. Or let's say the image ad specifically for the mobile devices and so forth. So you can select different ad formats for different devices being either the tablet or a laptop and so forth, and different ad formats given across an example. The other form of targeting, guys, is choosing the websites or the ad slots. Now, Google gives across a great opportunity to advertisers to pick and choose various websites on where the ad can be shown across, guys. Now, if today I have got a website for which I'm trying to promote across, let's say I'm taking across example of, let's say, Flipkart. I do want to promote it across. And give me 1 second. All right, so website slots I was talking about, I'm sorry. The website slots, if I am Flipkart, I can pick and choose where my ad should come. Is it on NDTV? I want to show my ad on the right-hand side. Is it on New York Times? Is it on several other websites where I want to show my ad? So if I am Flipkart, I go into Google AdWords and I create across these banner ads and so forth. All right, I'll be creating across advertisements, and I'll be showcasing them on various different websites where I can pick and choose. I can decide to choose, show my banner ad onto, let's say, ndtv.com, onto several other websites of my choice. And that happens only within Google AdWords. Now I'll decide across on the websites on the basis of my audience. What is the taste and preference of my audience, which are more likely to get converted? I'll try to select only those websites, all right, as an advertiser where the end audience has got more probability to come and take across, you know, and take do an action and so forth. So that's more to do with the overall targeting, guys. The next thing with the targeting is the PPC cycle. It all starts with the PPC, as in the pay-per-click overall, starts with selecting a keyword first, then going ahead and writing the ads, the headline in the description line 1 and description line 2 after the keyword selection. Then after writing ads, it's all about selling and putting across your bids. And number 4th, once the bid has been put in across and the ad will start getting displayed and users will click and redirect to your site, right? Once those clicks comes in, you pay for the search engines and the overall measurement aspect starts building up, right? The data starts pouring in and then you look at the data and then measure how's the performance like and so forth. If there have been improvement areas while doing the measurement, all those should be implemented. Right, so this is the PPC cycle, guys. Let me know if in case you guys are comfortable, any questions you have, so that I can go ahead and take that further, please. Can I get a quick confirmation from you guys? Are you guys all okay? Chaitanya, Goresh, Prasanjit, any questions, guys? Are you all okay? All right, thanks, Chaitanya. And thank you, Goresh. All right, so what we can do, all right, so let's continue with these 4 more slides and then we'll take a break. I was thinking of giving you a break, guys. Now, before you go ahead and get started with any advertisement, guys, it's all absolutely important to understand your business operation for the web, the business which the product which the business is offering. Also know the audience, the people who purchase across your product, what sort of people are they, where are they located and so forth, what kind of other likeliness, other interest area do they have. Also determine your product and service, your product or services offered to the users, and also determine the actions you want users to perform through your ad. And at the end, measure and evaluate your overall results and so forth. There are 3 R's of PPC, guys. It's been said that these are great R's. One is the reach. Now, advertisers, they do have the overall option of picking and choosing any specific targeting location which they want to. There are more than 6 billion queries which happens across daily. So whether a business has got a smaller area to focus on or a larger area to focus on in terms of the reach, that can be done. Display ads, they do come across multiple devices in different formats. All right, the second R, guys, is the relevance. Relevance, if we talk about, it's all about choosing the keywords that describe your business. So the ads will be shown only when user performs search using a relevant keyword and so forth. Then the other one is ROI, the third R says, with the pay-per-click, you can go ahead and measure across the performance on various matrices, and you do not really need to rely across on several assumptions and so forth, right? So ROI is the other thing. So you pay only when users reach your website and so forth. Now, how do we search, guys? If we talk about search engine users, people find across answers to their questions. So people type in across their questions and they try to look for more ideas through new videos and so forth. People always think in terms of concepts and not words. The concepts are then translated into words which serve as a keyword to perform search on search engines. Now users, the search engine users, if we talk about, they always have expectation from the searches they perform. If those expectations are, you know, not there, then definitely users will not come back to the search engine. So in order to get this process going, users should be offered across the results which they are expecting, and it's the publisher only, that'll do. Now also, if search results are not as expected, users refine on finding satisfactory results, search results, users clicks on one of the results to explore deeper. Right, so the search ad is an opportunity for the advertiser to attract users and also convert them into customers, right? That's what the overall objective is, right? Search ad is an opportunity for advertisers to attract users and convert them into customers. Now connecting with searches, guys, whenever there is a click on the ad by the search engine user, he or she has got a overall expectation, some expectation from the advertisement, and whenever the ad is being clicked, the ultimate thing which opens up is the landing page. Now, landing page is the first page user sees after clicking your ad. Now, search is non-interruptive marketing, guys, and interruptive marketing model provoking information sought by the users, and users may become customers. All right, now the users may become customers if the landing page provides the required information and so forth. Now the other part of the advertisement, guys, is refining across your connection. We've spoken about this. We can go ahead and create across a campaign and select across. We can streamline it further by having keywords of our choice, by having location, geographical location of our choice, Plus, we can decide across on the devices where our ad should be shown across, whether it's more on tablet or on PC and so forth. And plus, we can display ads to user based on the time and date. All right. When I know that this is the time when maximum conversion comes in, so let's go ahead and do that. That's all. Right, so these are various defining our connections, refining purposes. Also, with the frequency of clicks on your ads and the conversion rate, you can decide the amount you pay for a click. You can go ahead and look into the conversion table. All right, in the Google AdWords, there's something called the conversion bar. One can look into the overall conversions up and see how many conversions have come in, right, in the conversion table. So you can redirect, you should redirect users to pages on the site that can answer users' question, providing a relevant page to the users. Providing a relevant page to the users based on keywords can increase the conversion rate also. And these paid search provides data to help you track your conversion, and data on keywords, whether it's a search query, the best ads, the etc., helps you bid much more better. All right, so account hierarchy is something, guys, which we have already covered, so I'm not going to take that across. And then will come in the paid search auction and the quality score part. Absolutely, I'll be sharing this across this PPT. So we can go for a break now, guys, and we'll meet after a 15 minutes break, and then we'll take it further from there. All right. So I'm putting myself onto mute, and then we'll meet after the break. Make sense? Right, Prasenji, Goresh, and Chaitanya? All right, perfect. So I'm just putting myself onto mute. All right, so let's get started after the break, guys. Just trying to check if you guys can hear me. All right, so Chaitanya, Goresh, and Prasenjit. All right, perfect. Thanks for replying in. Now, the next thing, guys, is I was explaining about the auction part, and there are a few more things which, so these are the all basics, guys, which we are understanding today. Once this piece of information from the theoretical point is being understood, then only we'll be going ahead and putting them across into action. All right. So once we'll, you know, start working on the AdWords platform and create, when we'll create across ads, then you will be, you know, able to relate what all we studied theoretically, it's all implemented over here. Before I move further, I would like to give you a glimpse of how an AdWords panel really looks like, and how do the various different ads are being created in that. Let me just open across one of the AdWords account. Give me a second. Now, this is an AdWords account, guys, which I'm sharing in front of you of a particular client of mine. They are into the medical industry. It's a hospital, basically, which is based out of New Delhi, India. And over here, okay, one second. Right. Now, this is an AdWords platform. I'll definitely be teaching you how do we really go step by step in terms of creating a campaign, in terms of creating an ad groups. As for the overall, what do you say, hierarchy, which we have understood so far earlier. Right, so we'll start with creating an account, which is level one. Then we'll be going on to level number two, which is creating a campaigns. And then level three, which is creating ad groups. Setting up our bids, putting across bids for the keywords. We'll be seeing how do we create the ads, how do we create the keywords, how do we set up the keywords, and how do we put in across the maximum bids, the maximum amount which we are willing to pay. Now, if you try to see, we are on the very first tab, which is campaigns over here. The campaign level reporting is right over here in front of us. And this reporting, which you will see, it's for the last 30 days. Okay. Now, look, now the campaign level reporting, all the campaigns which are over here, all the campaigns which are mentioned over here, their performance report is right in front of us for the last 30 days. The campaign number one has got a budget of 500 Indian rupees a day. Second, third, fourth, they all have their respective budgets per day. Now, one thing is clear, the budgets, guys, are first of all set up on a campaign level, all right, not at the ad group or the keyword level or so forth, or even the ad group level. The budgets are set up on the campaign level first of all, plus they are the budgets are per day, on per day basis. So if it's 500 rupees, it's 500 rupees per day per campaign. Similarly, the other campaign, it would be again per day thing. Now, the reporting, after the ad has been created, underneath every campaign, keywords have been linked and so forth, the reporting says that how many number of times the ad has been shown, which have been under this campaign, 3,641 times. As in, impressions means the number of times the ad has been shown. Just giving you a small image, guys. This might give you a small visualization, understanding of how campaigns perform, the overall reporting thing, how does it really come across. So out of 3,641 times the ad has appeared, 238 times there has been clicks onto them, which means interactions. So interactions is another name for clicks, guys. And there is another metric, guys, which we are being offered by Google AdWords, and that is called interaction rate. Interaction rate or click-through rate means the same thing. interaction rate or click-through rate, CTR, which is calculated across as number of clicks divided by number of impressions multiplied by 100. So number of clicks is 238 in this case, divided by number of impressions is 3,641. Excuse me, multiplied by 100, if we do, it will give us 6.54%. What exactly it means is that out of so many number of times, how much percentage of times our ad was being clicked. So out of 100 times our ad was being appeared, 6.54 times it has got clicks, right? It has received clicks. Now, you know, interaction rate or click-through rate, higher it is, better it is, guys. Now, the way this interaction rate always moves up is when you have your advertisement and your landing page, and your keyword, three things in sequence. There's a specific theme which is linking all these three things together. Now, for an example, let me show you about CTR improvement, what people do when it comes down to improving CTR. I'm going on to google.com. All right, in this page, if you type in, when I typed in buy iPhone 6, what you can see, the wording, the search query said iPhone 6, and over here also in the headline of this text ad, there is iPhone 6 text. At least there's something which is similar, all right? It's not at all like, you know, it's a generic, advertisement. It doesn't say we sell everything, we sell phones and so forth. It is actually talking about the similar product which the search query also mentioned. So it's absolutely in our hands as an advertiser to make sure that for every search query or every keyword we select, there's a customized ad created across for every different type of a keyword. All right, if there is going to be, let's say, one ad for which, you know, which will be appearing across for thousands of various different keywords, that will not lead to great CTR, that will not lead to great, relevancy part. So as you can see, the relevancy part over here, one is the keyword, the first step, the second is the ad copy is right over here. And let's say if you'll click onto the ad, the page which will open up will also show iPhone 6 related stuff. It's not that a page is coming up which has got several, mobile phones in place, Apple iPhone 6, Apple iPhone 7 and so forth. It's nothing of that sort. So this is way too much specific targeting, and these kind of works always lead to better CTR. Search engines do appreciate this kind of work, and also the search engine visitors or the users, even they appreciate this. They like this. I mean, you can well imagine if you yourself are looking for an iPhone 6 for yourself, you go ahead and type in across the keyword, whatever it may be, buy iPhone 6 for 16 gigabytes, one online and so forth, whatever your request is or whatever your need is. And the moment you get to see an ad speaking the same language which your search query was, and the moment you click onto the ad, even the landing page, the page which opens up after clicking the ad, even that landing page has got a product which is similar to what was being asked for. It's not mixed up with several different products. It's not a different product altogether. So these are few ways through which CTR improves, guys. And also there's something called quality score, which I'll talk about. So that's how one digital marketer or one Google AdWords person gets differentiated from the other Google AdWords expert or a Google AdWords professional. We'll keep learning this, guys. And once we'll do the live sessions in terms of creating ads and so forth, things will get much more clearer. I hope everybody is clear with calculation of interaction rate or click-through rate. These are the two names. I'm repeating again. It's number of clicks in the numerator, which is 238, divided by in the denominator, it's number of impressions, which is 3,641, multiplied by 100, that gives us the interaction rate or the click-through rate. Now, the average cost per click has been for this particular campaign being 43 rupees 43 paisa per click. That's the average. What average means is in certain situations, when I say certain situations, out of these 238 situations, 238 clicks. Every click was not at all, of a standard pricing, which Google charged us. Sometimes it would have been 45, sometimes it would have been 40. It's an average altogether of 238 clicks, the price. So whatever amount got deducted in total, it was 10,336. If we divide this total amount which got spent, which Google charged us for this campaign, 10,336.25 paisa divided by 238 clicks, it gives us an amount of 43 rupees and 43 paisa per click. All right. Now there is another thing, guys, which is called conversions. Now conversions at the end of the day are very essential to be calculated. At the end of the day, if you are not having numbers in your with you, that how much profit your business made just because of these advertisements which you are running, you're creating and running, you will not be able to justify. I mean, we were talking about that. You'll not be able to justify that the activity which you are doing is a fruitful activity or not. Now, for getting to know whether the performance was great or not, there's something called conversion setup. Every particular business has got a different definition to conversions. Now, let's say if I talk about Flipkart only, which we were talking a while back, Flipkart's overall conversion definition might be the product sale. So whatever number of products get sold across on the website as a result of Google AdWords, that would be calculated and would be recorded across. So for an e-commerce website, in short, the definition of a conversion is a sale, more or less. For a non-e-commerce website, let's say if I talk about maybe for a website like NDTV, which doesn't have anything to be sold across, in this kind of a website, maybe they're looking for more number of email newsletter subscriber, right? So more the number of email newsletter subscriber they'll get as a result of Google Ads, they'll be more than happy. So that's the email newsletter subscriber is the, let's say, what do you say, the definition of conversion. Now another website, let's say this BLK Hospital one, which I was talking about, for which the campaign I was showcasing you, in this there could be a lead capture form, in the sense the moment somebody goes onto the landing page of this website, there would be a form fill up functionality. The visitors would be expected to fill up their first name, last name, and so forth, and ultimately it will give across a conversion, a form fill up, or a lead, whatever you want to call that, right? And their sales team will call them up, call these people who are submitting across their details later on, and there would be a follow up from the sales team, and there would be certain conversion in the offline world by calling up people and so forth. Till the online thing, it was only the form fill up thing which was being done across in the entire sales cycle. So every form fill up was being defined across as a conversion in that case. So conversion value, the conversion definition basically differs across from business to business, guys. All right. And the other thing is cost per conversion. So four conversions came in. Let's say four form fill ups came in as a result of, what do you say, out of all the 238 clicks. So 238 clicks resulted into four conversions. 3,641 was the highest. These many number of times ad was being shown, was being visible by various people, 3,641. And out of that, 238 only clicked. And out of 238 click only, four actually submitted across their details in the form. Now, those four conversions happened, and the price, the total price which was being spent across, was 10,336. So 10,336 divided by four, if we'll do, it will give us the cost per conversion. For every single conversion to happen, we had to spend across 2,500 rupees and so forth. Now, all these things, guys, Google AdWords gives us. We have to punch in across budget from our side, how many impressions, interactions, and interaction rate, and average cost and cost came in. This is something which Google AdWords gives us as the campaign keep performing and so forth. But the conversion, for the conversion and cost per conversion to be calculated across, there's a process of setting up conversion. Like I said, the conversions guys are very much subjective. They are very, they keep changing from business to business, in scenario to scenario. That's why we have to go ahead and shape that up or set that up. All right, so we'll see how do these conversions are being set up. Hope that helps. Let me know if there are further questions, guys. And give me a second. All right, so I'm just going to speak further more about various other things, guys, and then we'll, many more things will keep getting clear, and we will be able to implement them while doing the practicals. Now, the paid search auction, I told you that a bid has been put in across, and somebody did ask me, do we bid in across for a keyword? I did say yes. Well, the bid can be done at two levels, guys. One is the ad group, and the other is the keyword for sure. Ad group consists of a bundle of keywords. So ad group has got, ad group is the level number three. If you remember, this was something which we covered across in the last week, the overall level stuff, the hierarchy. Ad group, which is at level three, has got ads and keywords underneath it in the level four. All right, so the overall bid, which is the maximum amount which we as advertisers are willing to pay, is set up either on a keyword, each keyword basis, or we can set up across on an ad group. When we are creating across a campaign, you know, we always start with campaign creation, and then the second thing which Google AdWords asks is things underneath the ad group level. You know, in the ad group level, there would be a default bid which Google AdWords will ask us. We will mention the default bid. That default bid in that particular ad group will get automatically applicable for all the keywords underneath that respective ad group. Now later on, when you have set up everything in the ad group, then later on you can go ahead and individually change across the bids for every single click, every single keyword in that ad group. That can be done. Otherwise, you can put in across a bid, just one bid for every single keyword in the ad group level. Let me show you that. And I will encourage guys, if in case you have any question, please feel free to ask. Now, last time when we were on AdWords, last time in the sense, I mean, like just like a 5 minutes back, I'm meaning to say, I had shown you all these different matrices which were there. But as you can see, none of the matrices over here talks about the maximum CPC, the maximum amount which we as an advertiser want to pay, maximum CPC or bid. Maximum CPC and bid means the same thing. Now, instead of campaigns, now let's shift onto the ad group level. So I've clicked onto the ad group level number three, basically, which is there, level number three of a AdWords account. Over here, you can see the ad group name is given, and it also shows underneath which campaign this ad group is being clubbed under. Plus, is it eligible in the sense, I mean, is it eligible or is it paused? If it's paused, then it will definitely show it's not eligible, it's paused. Then the default maximum cost per click on an ad group level. Now, this is the bid, guys. Now, wherever you have any questions, guys, wherever you feel stuck, the best thing is to go ahead and use these question marks. You know, take the cursor to the question marks, and then they'll give you much more better explanation and clear explanation. I would say better. I mean, definitely it might become technical also, but just try to gain some more knowledge by taking these cursor to the question marks. Now over here, the default maximum CPC, guys, is the bid which is being set up across on the ad group level. Now underneath this ad group, if we talk about, let's say one of the ad group is topics, it might have 50 keywords underneath it. I'm just assuming. There can be 50, there can be 15, there can be 80, there can be 100, whatever number of keywords. Every keyword underneath this ad group will have a by default bid of 5 rupees per click. Either this is one, or we can go to the keywords directly. Let's go to the keyword section. And over here you will find maximum CPC there for every single keyword also. All right, you can go ahead and put changes to the bids whichever way you want to. It's just by going ahead and clicking on the price, only the maximum CPC for every single keyword. So click on to this, and then you will see it says the ad group default bid was 30 rupees, but you have changed it to 50. You know, this keyword would have been part of a particular ad group, and for that ad group, I mean, definitely every keyword is part of some or the other ad group. Now, the ad group were which under which this keyword is clubbed under has got a default bid of 30. But individually, we have gone ahead and increased the bid for this keyword to 50. So you can, first of all, put in across a bid at ad group level, but can change the bids for every single keyword, guys, later on at your own wish. I'm going back to the ad groups level one again, once again. So I told you it for every ad group, the name of the campaign is being shown, that underneath which campaign this ad group is, what's the status, what's the maximum CPC. And for this ad group level reporting also, we get across the number of clicks, the number of times the ad was being shown, which is impressions, the CTR being achieved, the average cost per click also. All right, the average cost per click is, and the maximum cost per click are two different things. Maximum cost per click, guys, is the default bid, is the bid basically which you are willing to pay, an amount which you are willing to pay, and average CPC is the amount which you have ultimately paid. You will never find across scenarios when your maximum CPC, the maximum amount which you're willing to pay, to be lower than the average cost per click which you have paid. Average CPC would be on the lower side. Hope it makes sense. Now, how this particular cost per click is being decided, we'll definitely learn that part also. Why is it that, you know, if today I have told Google AdWords that my overall capacity, my overall pocket allows me to spend only 5 rupees per click. And, you know, if I have told this is the maximum amount. And if I have told this, then why is it that Google is charging either 4, either 3, either 2, which is lesser than that? What's the overall mechanism behind it? What's the overall logic? And how does that get really calculated? We'll understand. So Google, you know, tries to give across maximum benefit to its advertiser and its also search engine users. Google tries to keep everybody happy and tries to give across maximum return on investment to the advertiser and better results to its search engine users who have come all the way to search in for something or the other by typing in their search queries, right? So that's the role of the Google as a technology. Now, the average cost per click is also being mentioned over here. The total cost, what has been the overall average position? Sometimes the advertisement underneath this ad groups would have been, you know, getting a cross position of 2, somebody sometimes 1, sometimes 3. But what is the average position like? It's been 1.1. Now, converted clicks, cost per converted clicks, or the click conversion ratio, all these things are something which gets provided across only in a scenario when we have conversions being set up. And once I'll show you the conversion setup, then these things will get clear, guys. All right. Wherever you have any question, I can understand there would be few things which might not be, you might not be able to get it right now, but as you refer to the recordings, you'll come onto this particular panel, then you'll get to understand. So then I say, what's average position? Sure, I'll tell you. So average position, if I'll tell you, let's say if I'm going on to Google AdWords and there is this keyword called buy iPhone 6 again. Now, as you can see, Flipkart has got a position number 1 and Amazon has got a position number 2. This is called average. This is called position, first of all. So Flipkart has achieved position number 1. Amazon has achieved position number 2 for a keyword, this one. All right. Now, the thing is, Flipkart sometimes might be achieving position number 1, sometimes might be achieving position number 2 or 3 or 4 and so forth for, let's say, similar set of keyword. Now, out of all the instances when the advertisement of Flipkart have come in, the position of the ad would have got tracked by Google in every single instance. Like I said, sometime it's been most, majority of the time it's been 1, and then the second best has been the second position after the first position. So the average is being taken out that, let's say, 300 times the ad has been ad has appeared. Out of 300 times, how many times the ad appeared on the first position, how many times it appeared on the second, how many times it appeared on the third. On an average, the position is then being reported by Google, right? Sometimes it was first position, sometimes being second, sometimes being third. So what Google does, Google goes ahead and takes an average of all the positions and so forth and gives across an average position. Hope that helps, Chidane. Let me know if in case you have a follow-up question. All right, it's okay. All right, I hope you have understood, and if not, I can still go ahead and, all right, you got it, perfect. I can anytime go ahead and repeat things also. Now, this is about the ad group level settings. And there are several other things, like when you click onto ads, the text ads, these are the text ads, guys. Now, these are also being created across by the advertisers. We'll see how do we go ahead and create them across. Okay. Now, there are ways through which we go ahead and enter across the headline, and also we are responsible for putting across the description line, the URL, and so forth. So there are several elements underneath of that and so forth. All right. Just give me a second. All right, so I was talking more about this, and I have shown you in between the ad groups. All right, so I was talking about setting up a bid on the keyword and an ad group basis, guys. Now, we as an advertiser, they pay to search engine when a user clicks onto our ad in order to get website traffic. You can bid multiple times as an auction is dynamic, guys. Now, this is another thing. If today you have put in across a bid, it doesn't mean that you cannot change it. You can change it n number of times in a day. All right, so bid multiple times as an auction is dynamic across, guys. And also, with regards to the paid search auction basis, know how to bid. Once you know how to bid and be aware of your competitors' bid to ensure it's profitable. Well, it's not so easy to get to know about the competitors' bid, but if you can be aware, it's good to ensure it's much more profitable. We got ad positions, guys. Now, ad positions, when I was talking about ad positions, the average ranking position we were talking about. Right. Just a second. All right. So, ad position, guys, if we talk about, it's like this. I hope you guys remember. Let me just remove this slide for a second. Let me ask each one of you. What is the maximum number of advertisements which Google allows in the first page top, the top listings? And also, how many are allowed, how many search ads are allowed in the bottom part of the search ad? So how many are allowed in the top? How many paid ads are allowed in the first page, in the topmost position of the search engine result page, and how many paid ads are allowed in the bottom? All right, Prasanjit says 10. Well, Prasanjit, the question is how many paid ones are being allowed? So Kore says 3/4 and Chitana says 4. Yes, the 4. All right, so you got the question. Perfect. So for 4, the paid ones are 4 on the top, and how many are the unpaid one? So after 4, paid, there are unpaid, which is 10, like you said, Prasanjit. And then we have, again, paid versions, maximum. Right? We have got another paid version, which is maximum. 3 on the bottom. So you have 4 maximum on the top, paid, and then 10 unpaid, which are definitely going to be there. And then 3 maximum in the paid one. So it's 4, 10, and then 3. 4 on the top, then 10, and then 3, guys. All right. Now, with that being said, what you can see over here, guys, there is some understanding about how these paid ads rank across. Okay, the way these two examples are being taken across is that the first one is more of a, what do you say, assumption which people have got, and the second one is what the actual thing is. Now, actual thing in the sense, this happens on the ground, and the first one, which is assumption, which is more, it's more of a, you know, a thing which people feel that it happens, but it genuinely, it doesn't. What is the assumption thing is like? The assumption with regards to every single ad position, the assumption says that more an advertiser bids across, better are the chances of, you know, better are the chances in terms of getting the website rank higher. So if you would see this, the the advertiser which is willing to pay across $1 per click, right? The assumption says it's ranking on the topmost. The second advertiser, which is the second highest bid after $1, it's 75 cents, is willing to, you know, get across the second position, wants the second position. The one which gets the third position is the one who's got the third highest, who's the third highest bidder. The fourth highest bidder gets the fourth position. Fifth highest bidder gets the fifth position. Now, on the basis of the bidding, you know, bid is the maximum amount which you're willing to pay, which you do not want to share. I mean, it won't get shared with the others. So that's another disadvantage. You won't be able to get to know about your competitors so easily, and even they won't get to know about you so easily. Now, the assumption says that the higher you bid, the better your, what do you say, ranking comes out to be. But not just the search engine ranking is dependent upon the, what do you say, bid part. There are more things which decides other than, you know, other than the bid, which decide where the ad is going to rank like. Now, over here, the right-hand side, guys, the right-hand side tab shows the actual scenario. What happens is, in this actual scenario, what you can see is the fourth position ad. This is the ad rank position number four. The ad rank position number four is the one who was bidding across the highest, right, with $1 being there and so forth. And the first highest bidder is this. Second highest bidder is, it's this one, right, which is Sharp USA. Now, after $1, it's 75 cents, second highest bidder, and then comes in the third highest bidder being 50 cents, and then 25, and then 10. The surprising thing is that the higher the bid, it doesn't really guarantee you, you know, ranking on the top. Now, what is that reason that the third highest bidder, what is that reason that the third highest bidder, which is nelmotv.com and so forth, the third highest bidder is ranking on the top, and also the fifth bidder, the fifth highest bidder is actually, all right, so they're ranking somewhere perfectly, but the first highest bidder is Samsung, and they're ranking across on the fourth position. All right. Now, this is happening just because Samsung would have done something great in terms of increasing their quality score. All right. So, it's the bid plus quality score, guys, which determines the ad rank. I'm going to talk more on that. Bid and the quality score. Now, what are those things which comes under quality score? We'll talk about this in detail now. And give me a second. Absolutely right, Chaitanya. It's paid 7, 4, and 3, and in between 4 and 3, it's 10, right, which is the organic. All right, so the first highest bidder is achieving this fourth position. The third highest bidder is achieving the first position. The person who is achieving the first position, the advertiser which is achieving the first position is not the highest bidder, is the third highest bidder. Despite of bidding the third highest bid, right, they're on the top. So 50 cents, and which is lesser than $1 and lesser than 75 cents, and still being on the top. Now what happens is, this is the reality, right? And cost per click basically is non-linear and does not determine the ad position. So let's look into this. Now this is the formula, guys, which decides the ad rank. This is the formula which decides the ad rank. And it takes into consideration the maximum bid, the quality score, and the ad extension. Okay. Now quality score, I've shown you where exactly do you get to see that. Let me just go ahead and show you once again. All right, so I'll take this. So I was showing you the maximum bid, quality score, and ad extension. These are the three things which determines the ad rank. And maximum bid, where do we really get to see this? I have shown you that, right? It's a maximum, what do you say? Maximum bid has got a different name, which is the cost per click, maximum CPC. Maximum bid or maximum CPC means the same. Then comes in the quality score. Yes, I was showing you the quality score. Give me a second. All right, so here we have one of the AdWords account. In this, when you go to the ad section, is right over here. All right, let's go to keywords. Now with the keywords, guys, what you can see, there's this bubble right next to every keyword. But you'll take this, cursor on the bubble of every single keyword, you can see quality score. Now quality score, guys, is calculated on a scale of 1 to 10. 1 being the least and 10 being the highest. For every single keyword, there's a quality score being calculated. Over here, it's 8 out of 10. Similarly, for the other one, it's 8 out of 10 only. And then this is 6 out of 10 and so forth. Now this entire position funda, guys, position of the advertisement. Right. So the overall ad rank, guys, for your advertisement, for your competitor one and your competitor two, what's going to be the position? We'll try to judge this on the basis of a calculation. On the basis of a calculation which Google only does, and we don't get to see that. But as a digital marketer, we should be knowing about that. So there are three things search engines needs to take into account, which determines the ad rank using the following components. Number one is the maximum bid. So maximum bid, which we are willing to pay, we'll be taking that into action, the quality score, and then the ad extensions. Now over here, guys, the formula which we are taking in order to measure the ad rank is maximum bid, which you have mentioned, multiplied by the quality score plus ad extensions. All right, quality score plus ad extension. Now the overall, detailed explanation of this ad rank formula, which Google does, which Google puts into action in order to measure the ad rank and so forth, it's right over here. So let's say your website, with your website, you have put in across a bid of $1 per click all right, $1 per keyword and so forth. And then you are multiplying it with quality score and ad extension. Now, quality score is also given across on a scale of 1 to 10, ad extension on a scale of 1 to 10. We have got a formula in this ad rank where 80% of the credit is for the just the quality score stuff, and the rest 20% is to the ad extension. All right. So we've got information from your websites, your website, and then two other and so forth, and then the multiplication with quality score and ad extension. So bid is 100%. You go ahead and multiply it, which is $1, multiply it by quality score, which is 80%, and ad extension, which is 20%. Now, this is the bifurcation, guys, of quality score and ad extension. Earlier, we were not looking at what you said, doing the bifurcation. It was just an add-on. The quality score is calculated across, right, is calculated across on a scale of 0 to 10. And also the score of quality score is going to be 80% only, right? And for the ad extension, it's 20%. Now, all in all, with the hypothetical situation, we have got the numbers right in front of us. Let's say your information, which is my information, is $1. And the quality score which we have received for this has been 6 out of 10. But now 6 is like, what do you say? 6 is the quality score, right? So 6 is the quality score which can always improve across. So the quality score needs to be improved. And then ad extension, which is 6, and that is measurable for 20%. So the overall thing, if we talk about quality score, is taking into account 80%, and ad extension is taking into account, right, the 20% and so forth. Now with this, the competitor one, if we talk about the competitor one, has also got a bid amount same as $1 multiplied by quality score, right? The quality score has been 7, and you're multiplying it by 0.8 because it's right, it's quality score plus ad extension. So in order to get to know the ad rank, we got the overall maximum bids being done across by all the three, for your website, for your competitor website one, your competitor website number two, and so forth. And you multiply this, you multiply the bids by quality score plus ad extension. And in this quality score plus ad extension formula also, the quality score is accountable for 80% and rest 20% for the ad extension. So that's why we have multiplied quality score with 0.8, ad extension with 20% with 0.2. All right, so when you go ahead and do the overall calculation, guys, 1 multiplied by 4.8 plus 1.2. So 6 was the quality score and 80% was the weightage. And similarly, 6 was the quality score and 2%, 20% was the weightage. So when you multiply all of these, the ad rank score, which comes out to be, is 6. Similarly, in competitor 1, the ad rank score, the ad rank score is 5.6, and in competitor 2, the ad rank score is 5, guys. If we try to put them across into a dice, a descending order, it'll be like 6 would be on the top, 5.6 number 2, and then 5 being number 3 from number competitor 2. All right, so you've got these ad rank, guys. Number, so these are the overall positions which have been achieved. So the ad rank score were in all those scenarios, it's going to be 6. If you do not do the quality score plus and so forth, that would be, well, it's done like that only. All right, so you calculate quality score, you calculate the ad rank score. With this process, you multiply bid, you multiply bid with quality score being accountable for 80% and ad extension being accountable for 20%. So you've got the ad rank 6, 5.6 and 5. And the way it's going to work is the first position is going to be hold by the advertisement which has got the maximum ad rank, maximum ad, which is 6. And then the second one is this 5.6 and the third one is the 5, right? So this is ad rank, guys. Whenever you have any question, feel, or it's ad extensions, I'll just talk about, right? Ad extensions, what are these? Sure. Now what happens is ad extension, guys, I was telling you a while back that every single website or I'm just going on to Google. Let's say what I'm going to type in. All right, so let me tell you with this one. Now, what is ad extension? I was telling you whenever an ad is being created across a search ad, it always have a default elements. So the headline, this is headline one up till this, and this is headline two. All right. So this is headline two, guys, this one. Up till flat, basically. So this is a headline one, headline two, which is part of the ad. When we'll create ad, you'll get to know. And there is a display URL, which will also be put in by us. And then there is going to be some text, which will be put in by us. All right. But anything which is on top of all these things are called ad extensions, majorly. For example, you can see there are four links. There are four links which are pointing towards the internal page, all right, of the website. These are called citing extension. In short, anything which is an extension to the by default ad. The by default ad is more towards understanding the basic details and so forth. And right, and these ad extensions, when they are being created, they also get across a specific number or a quality score. All right. Got it. Now, these ad extensions, guys, when they have been received across with a certain quality score, then on the basis of this happens, right? So, ad extensions, which are the extra things, all right, extra, what do you say? Extensions, the ad extensions are over here, and similarly, one second. All right, so the way we have received across quality score, guys. For our ad, similarly, we get across ad extension score also, but we don't get to see this. In the AdWords panel, I had shown you that for every single keyword, the quality score was visible, right? That was very much there. What is the bid going on? That's also in our control. So the bid is in our control very much. Quality score is something which is also in our control, provided we do all the great things with regards to making the, what do you say, keyword selection to the ad copy writing to the end thing, which is the landing page copy. All right. All those three things helps in improving across the quality score. Once that's been improved and so forth, definitely you can have more, what do you say, more effort to be put in across an ad extension, because ad extensions, they do also have some numbers attached to it, some results, some you know, figures. And when ad extension is also going to be responsible for 20%, then we take that into account for giving us the ad rank. Now in this case, it was, like I said, first, second, third, we all understood the ad rank number and so forth. So I hope the ad rank question, quality score depends on the right keyword selection. Quality score depends upon three major things. One is the quality score is dependent upon the relevancy part, Chaitanya, which I was talking about. The keyword has to be relevant to the ad copy, and ad copy content also has to be in sequence with all the other things, which is the landing page content. Let me just show you. One second. So quality score, right over here. As you can see, quality score is dependent upon three things: click-through rate, ad relevance, and landing page relevance. So click-through rate is something which I've already told you, that if we want to have a better click-through rate, it all goes without saying that our advertisement should be focused and should be created across multiple ads, should be created across for multiple keywords and so forth. So expected click-through rate, the ad relevance, which is pretty much subjective, and also landing page experience. All right, these are the three things which improves across our quality score, and that's the thing which is where our quality score is based upon. So then it says number of impressions divided by clicks is multiplied by 100 is the it's number of clicks divided by number of impressions, the other way around. So CTR stands for, if you just use my Word doc, which I have written this. All right, so not the ROS. I just want to show you click-through rate. All right, not even the match types today. That might get done tomorrow. Here we go. CTR. All right, so CTR stands for number of clicks divided by number of impressions multiplied by 100. So let's say in scenario one, you have got your first individual who types in buy iPhone 6. Ad shows up there. So the moment ad shows up, there's one impression. Then there is no click on the ad. So it means one impression and zero click. Okay, second individual, ad shows up, one impression, no click on the ad again. It means two impressions, all right, and zero click. The third individual, the ad shows up, and it means there is one specific impression, and let's say there is one click on the ad. So three impressions and one click, right? So more the number of clicks for the similar number of impressions will always improve across your CTR. All right, so that's the definition of a CTR, number of clicks multiplied by number of impressions into 100. And also I give you information about the way through which quality score can be improved. Now the quality score, the way it's been given across for keyword guys, it's also given across for ad extensions, which I was telling you, something which is on, which is something more to most of the keywords these days, right? Now over here, ad extensions, reporting thing is there for sure, but the quality score is not. Quality score is used across by Google internally and so forth. So Google will use quality score in order to make a judgment on the ad rank position. Makes sense? Let me move back. All right, so we understood the ad rank. Now talking more about the quality score, I just told you, quality score is an automated rating, guys, which Google AdWords provide us. It's an automated rating by search engines for ads and the pages based on the user experience. There are three things on the basis of which the quality score is dependent. I've shown you just now, expected click-through rate, ad relevance, and landing page relevance. A quality score, guys, always keeps fluctuating when the auction occurs. whenever there's an auction, everybody is trying to put in across their maximum one which they're willing to pay. Quality score goes up and down and so forth. And quality score may differ also based on the devices which people are using across, right? Whether it's a mobile phone or a desktop and so forth. Plus, quality score may differ based on the different times, say noon versus midnight and so forth. And also, quality score would differ based on for different geographical location also. All right. So for different geographical location for also devices such as mobile phone versus desktop, and also at different times, say noon versus midnight and so forth. So quality score would differ based on the following. All right, so there's this slide, guys, which talks about need for ad rank. How do we improve the ad rank? Well, ad rank helps search engines order the ads on search results pages. That's number one. And quality score forces advertisers to create ads that are relevant to users. All right. Well, users who click onto relevant ads, they always get across relevant results and they become across the customers, absolutely. And the paid search focuses on displaying relevant ads of the searcher. So paid search focus, the one from, I'll just show you. So paid search focuses on displaying relevant ads to the searcher. Well, I hope you've understood paid search focuses. It's only these search results on the paid portion, right, at the topmost position. They're more focusing on delivering relevant ads to the searcher so that searchers don't get pissed off and so forth. Well, relevance increases always through click-through rates for ads which generate revenue for search engines. Absolutely. We've got an example over here, advertiser A and advertiser B. And with A, let's say the bid amount is 50 cents and the B amount is $1. All right. Now, these are the overall bidding, and if you multiply bid by CTR, that would be the total ad spend. So over here, it's 50 and then 10%, which is $2.5 and $1 and so forth. Now, conversion tracking, guys, is something which I'll be showing you. Like I told you, conversion tracking helps in measuring the performance of the paid search campaign, guys. All right. We can set up goals. We can choose how, the goals you want them to be achieved and so forth. You measure the performance and see what all things are working, what are not, and then analyze the matrices ultimately. So the best practices to accomplish your goals are to avoid bidding higher. So don't go for higher bidding, guys, straight away without even thinking. In the initial phase, definitely a bit off is needed, but later on the bid price will keep getting decreased and we will keep on increasing the quality score and so forth. One needs to ensure that ads focused on higher conversion and use matrices to analyze the paid search campaign. All right, so this is the targeting option one. I hope each one of you have understood the things. All right, so this is one. All right, let me just save paid search targeting option is the same, or it's absolutely the same. Now the targeting options, guys, we saw that the paid ads can be targeted on search network with the help of the keywords and in the display network. The targeting options are dependent upon the user interest and so forth. Now, paid search targeting options, guys, we talked about hierarchy review. You guys understood, and I believe we recall that. It's the overall AdWords account under the top, and then we have campaign one and campaign two. Right? So account includes basic elements such as billing and time zone and so forth. each campaign has unique targeting option. All right, so each campaign has got unique target options and through which it can be measured what's the performance of every single ad campaign and so forth. Now, ad groups is a campaign, follow the campaign targeting options. All right, so ad groups in a campaign, follow the campaign's targeting options and so forth. It's just all about getting to know from the others. We spoke about the networks, guys. Campaign must be on the search network or on either the display network. In search, we are actively using or seeking in for, you know, he or she is seeking in for a product or a service. In display, users get it distracted by ads while they search for information. All right, so that's with search and display network. The targeting options, guys, we understood earlier that the champagne level setting, if we talk about it in terms of targeting options, the campaign, sorry, is a campaign level. I was just reading out its H and it's not there. The campaign level and the ad group level settings, guys, is being shown over here when we were on the AdWords platform. So campaign level settings, guys, are over here. When you click onto campaign, underneath the campaign, so here are the settings, guys. These settings basically are done at a campaign level. Things like campaign start date, end date, ad schedule, for what all devices we want to run it, and what bid strategy, and several others. And then there are certain things which are done. Let me see. There are then certain other things which are done at a remarketing, at a ad group level, and I'll show you this. This will get much more clear when we create a campaign, guys. When we start making a campaign, the location for which we want to show our ad, the device on which we want to show our ad, whether it's a mobile only or a tablet only, and also the time frame for which our ad will come in, they all are controlled at a campaign level. Whereas at the ad group level, which is underneath campaign level, in that settings option, things like the placement settings, placement in the sense the websites on which the ad will appear across, contextual targeting, which includes across writing across the keyword, and Google will automatically pick up web pages from its display network, which has got content related to it, and the contextual targeting will be done on with regards to that. Then interest targeting. Interest targeting is another form of targeting mentioned across in the ad group level settings. It says, the interest targeting says that you can create your ads and then pick and choose people of your choice whose interest matches to what your stuff is matching across to. And that's how the interest targeting really works like. All right, so contextual targeting, interest targeting, and then the other one is the remarketing, right? So at the ad group level, one can go ahead and show across their products, show across their ads basically on the basis of the remarketing. Somebody has been to your website before, you can go ahead and show across a banner ad to that same person who has been to your website before. All right, so these are the things which are, operated across at different levels, whether it's a campaign level or an ad group level and so forth. Location targeting, I already mentioned that you can create across a camp, a company on google.com/business, and you can target users more specifically, different ads from different territories, different budget for different regions, and you can target users also based on the country, state, metro, cities, port, which was being done earlier, and so forth. Also, you do have, as an internet marketer, to have custom options in central places such as targeting public areas and so forth. All right, so this is our location. And then there is a targeting done at a device level. We have understood this. Target, one can decide on showcasing across the ad to people with a certain device. So you can target user based on the device on which they see your ads, whether it's on a tablet only or on a mobile phone or on only desktop or any two of them or none of them. The time frame targeting, guys, I had made you understand that we can go ahead and run across our ads on the timing as per our overall campaign's performance and also as per business. So I was giving you an example of a restaurant which runs across its ads only for 3 hours in the morning, 3 hours in the afternoon, and 3 hours in the evening, and so forth. So display ads come across in the different time frames depending upon what the, you know, where the end audience, if the end audience are coming across for a certain time period, then definitely it makes sense to showcase our ad at that point of time only. One can also adjust bids by time frames based on certain data. All right. So change the bids by time frames, ads for weekdays and weekends and so forth. The placement targeting is purely nothing, but it's all about going ahead and asking Google if these websites, these list of websites are there on which the ads can be part of. You know, with the ads on these websites, we want the ad, our advertisement to be there. That is called placement targeting. All right, so it is small but specific display inventory. It helps you to select and slot on individual websites. Right, on individual websites, you can slot across where your ads will be displayed. For example, the New York Times has more than 100 ad slots, and you can choose an ad slot to display your ad on the New York Times homepage or the classified and so forth. The contextual targeting, guys, now this is another form of targeting which I've already spoken about. What happens is, as an advertiser, you put in across a certain keyword, all right, in the AdWords, and then Google AdWords will do its work. Google AdWords will find out all the web pages which are part of the Google Display Network, which have got content related to this keyword being entered. Now, these pages which have got content related to the keyword being entered will be used across for showcasing across banner ads and so forth, right? So pages or sites have content that matches yours, you can select relevant keywords or topics to display your ads on them and so forth. And then we have interest targeting. This is more to do with what's the interest level of the people who come and, you know, create across, come onto search engines and do several searches and so forth. So we as advertiser can pick and choose the targeting from the interest level. It is based on user interest data recorded by search engines, and target users are also based on their interest shown in certain areas, guys, while browsing. Remarketing, I told you, it is all about going ahead and showing your ads only to those set of people who have been to your website before, right? Remarketing is that. So that's another form of marketing. We'll see these display marketing, guys, once we'll work onto this. Now, any questions, any doubts, guys, so far? Do let me know. Are we all good? As of now, good. All right. All right. So how about you, Goresh and Prasanjit? All right. Revise once again. Sure. Absolutely. Just give me... Can we just take a 5 minutes break? I'm just going to be back in 5 minutes, and then the last 10 minutes, we'll go ahead and revise it. Just give me 5 minutes. I'll be back. All right, guys. So let's do a small recap of what was being covered across. So I hope you are able to hear me, right? Just want to check if you can hear me. Please do acknowledge in the chat window. Chaitanya, Goresh, and Prasenjit. All right, perfect. Thanks, Goresh. So while doing a recap, thanks, Prasenjit, we've understood what is a click-through rate, the way it's being, it's one of the metric which Google AdWords gives us. And we always have to aim in to get across a higher CTR, a click-through rate, which is also called as an interaction rate, which we understood, right? Interaction rate. Now, the way it's being, improved across is on the basis of the relevancy. When we will be creating across our ads, we have to make sure that the keywords, the ads, and also the landing pages, which would be connected across to each other, they all are in same sequence of same theme. All right. We understood this. We also understood our match types. We didn't. The other thing is, today what we understood is the auction-based system, the CTR, all right, and all right. So these things, ad rank and all, I'll cover later on. We understood what is an ad rank, basically ad rank, like, I mean, 1, 2, 3, how do we judge and determine ad rank? We understood that part also. The ad rank, let me just use these slides again. All right, so we understood the overall bidding is something which doesn't affect across the ad rank to the core. There's also something called quality score, which plays a very vital role in the ranking of an advertisement. So as you can see, this is an assumption that higher you bid, better, I mean, you'll always be on the top. There can be situations when you're bidding the highest out of, as compared to your competitors, still you are ranking onto the bottom just because your quality score isn't that great. So there could be a reason why, that your ad can be ranking onto the bottom because of lower quality score. Quality score, we understood that it's calculated on a scale of 1 to 10, and there are three factors which determines quality score. Also, with regards to ad rank, we had a formula which takes into account the bid which we are willing bid, which is the amount which we are willing to pay, multiply by quality score and ad extension. 80% of the weightage is given to the quality score and 20% to the ad extension. The way we calculate, we get across, I mean, once we calculate, we have got some hypothetical figures for every single scenario. In our scenario, in our competitor one and competitor two scenarios, we have got the bid hypothetical one and quality score being given hypothetically, and ad extension score being given hypothetically. We have multiplied each one of them with 0.2 and with 0.8, just because 80% of the weightage is given to quality score and 20% weightage is given to ad extension. Once we'll multiply quality score with 0.8 because it's 80%, and once we'll multiply the ad extension score, which is which weighs for 20%, we get across a number by adding these two, and we multiply it ultimately by bid. That gives us the ad rank. The advertiser who has got the highest ad rank will be there on the first position. Ad extensions, I told you, these are the things which are more than the default ad. We'll definitely understand in our next session what are the various different types of ad extensions, guys. All right. Now, quality score also, we understood the quality score is dependent upon click-through rate, ad relevancy, and landing page relevancy. And it does fluctuate across numerous times whenever there is always an auction and so forth. So you have to go ahead and give across better experience to your visitors in order to improve the quality score and so forth. We understood the need for ad rank. We understood conversion tracking. Conversion tracking needs to be done. And conversion for every single website, is going to be determined differently. We'll see that tomorrow. We'll understand how conversion mapping is being done. targeting options, hierarchy also was being understood in the last session, account being on the level one, campaign taking across the level two position. Then level three is with ad group and level four with ads and keywords. All right. We understood that there are two networks, majorly the search and the display, and the targeting options when it comes down to the display network. At a campaign level, we can define the location, device targeting and time frame. Whereas at the ad group level, it's placement targeting. So guys, this is all theoretical. We will get to see when we'll create an account. We'll start with campaign creation. At campaign creation, all these things will be there in front of us. And then we'll jump on from campaign to the ad group level settings. And all these things would be there at that point of time also. Location targeting can be done across on a country, state, zip code, and so forth. Device targeting can be done. We can decide on which particular device do we want to run our ad. Do we only want to focus people who are using mobile devices or tablet devices or all three of them, including the desktop and so forth. Time frame targeting also, we understood that we can put in across certain alerts in our Google's campaign that this ad should run in the morning hours, this ad should run in the evening hours, this ad should run in the afternoon hours, depending upon what my business is like. Plus placement targeting, we can go ahead and define whether I want my ad to be there on some of the websites of my choice, whether it's on New York Times or on Forbes.com and so forth. Those websites should be part of the Google Display Network. Then we understood contextual targeting. If you're not very sure on which call websites should our banner ad or video ad should be presented across, then we can go ahead and use the contextual targeting option. What happens with that is we'll be entering across a certain keyword, and on the basis of that keyword, the various web pages will be scanned, which are part of Google search, the Google Display Network, and only those web pages will be pulled out, which have got content related to that keyword we'll mention. And on those websites which have been pulled out, the ads will be showcased on them. We'll see all this. Also, we spoke about interest targeting. In this interest targeting option, we can only select, we'll be able to give across instruction to Google that my ad should be shown across only to people who have got interest in such and such things. And then remarketing is another way of going ahead and making sure that our ad, I mean, this is another way of targeting. Over here, we try to showcase our ad not on the basis of interest or not on the basis of the websites we want to enter or not on the basis of, interest or content also. It's only on the basis of the users who have visited our website in the past, right? So remarketing is another one. That's all we have studied today. We'll see the live implementation of all these things, guys, as we move further in our upcoming sessions. Tomorrow we'll be meeting across at same time, and then I will start with the practical implementation. Some theoretical stuff is still to be done, and then followed with that practical implementation, where each and every step and I'll be taking across in the AdWords campaign, trust me, then it will the blocks will be built. You have blocks of information. You've got bits and pieces of information as of now, which probably might not give you a clear picture. It happens for sure. It might not give you a clear picture. It is just good to know information which you've got just now. But things will get much more clear when we'll work on a Google AdWords campaign, guys. All right. Hope it makes sense. Any comments, any questions, guys, before we wrap up our today's session? Are we all good? Are you all good, guys? All right. Thanks, Prasenjit, for acknowledging. Absolutely. I'll be sending across the PPT and the word for sure, Chaitanya. Perfect. Thanks, Chaitanya, for acknowledging. And thanks, Goresh. I'll be sharing across these documents with each one of you by the end of the day, guys. And we'll be meeting across tomorrow, same time. Take care. Thank you till then. And have a great rest of it. The website stuff, building across the website, I'll ask Nitin to actually send you the details. Right, Chaitanya? So Nitin has to share across the details about the website stuff. Perfect. Thanks, everyone. Take care and enjoy the rest of your day and enjoy your weekend. Take care. Bye now.